So you guys today are going to be making little mini pastas.
Always.
I don't know that mine will look like that.
Oh, it will. It will. They all look the same.
That's Picasso?
Picasso, yes. I'll show it to you in just a second. This is your poster, and most of my schools don't have this. I make it myself, so so the first thing to do, you guys aren't teaching this today, are you?
No.
All of the public schools I work in have this book. It's called Mouse Paint, and it's in the big book format. It's like a standard issue. Because learning about colors is kindergarten curriculum. So ask your teacher if she has this. This is,
I forgot to get this.
This is my copy.
Yeah, we should grab that sheet real quick.
First thing you're going to do, pardon me?
Grab that sheet.
Oh, okay.
I think it's the second drawer.
It's okay. The first thing you're going to do is the kids come in. Do they wear smocks
on? Yeah, we put the smocks.
Put their smocks on, sun to the rug. Do one of these going to read the story. That's why. Just to start off with. When you read children's books, it's always best if you're very familiar with the story yourself. So that when you hold it up, you just kind of talk through it. You know, you don't like have to keep going like this. And it's nice. You can kind of talk through it. So basically, the story of this book is these three little white mice. And there's a cat who likes to chase them. So they find three pots of paint, red, yellow, and blue. And so they jump in, and now we have red mouse, yellow mouse, and blue mouse. And it's cute. It uses four words like we danced in this world. And now they notice they've made puddles on the ground. So now, and it's good for kids to teach kids how to anticipate in reading. So now we have a red mouse and a yellow puddle. Uh-oh, what's going to happen? What do you think's going to happen? Red mouse goes in the yellow puddle. It's an orange puddle. Look at this mouse. He has orange feet. Then the next mouse, the yellow mouse, finds a blue puddle. And he dances and he swirls and he mixes the paint. What do you think is going to happen? We have a green puddle. And so we kind of go through the book that way. And then blue mouse goes in the red puddle. And what do we make? And the kids may tell you purple. And you're like, yes, purple. But it's violet. That's an art word, violet. And so now we have violet paint. Uh-oh. The mouse are all sticky and stiff because the paint's drying. So what do? They clean themselves off in whose water bottle? It's a water bottle. So now they're all clean. And they had this great idea. They're going to camouflage themselves. So they paint the paper red, yellow, and blue. They get some paint tape. And they leave a little spot white, you'll see, so they can still hide from the cat. Okay? So mouse paint goes over the three primary colors, red, yellow, and blue, and talks about the three secondary colors, orange, green, and green. This is another one called White Rabbit's Colorful Day. Same theory. White rabbit, long in different colors of paint, but at the end, white rabbit, instead of becoming white again, jumps in all the paints and he becomes brown rabbit and he jumps away. So either one of those books you're going to start off reading. Now we're going to talk about color. You guys have this great chart. So we learned what are our three primary colors. These are colors you cannot make no matter how many colors of paint you mix. Yellow and red and blue. Those are our three primary colors. Make paints with those if I mix them together. It's like art math. So here's a math problem. Yellow plus red gives me orange. And I would almost be tempted to maybe hide this with a piece of paper or something and make them guess. When I teach this, because I don't have that empty chart, I use markers. I use red, yellow, blue, green, orange markers. And then I write the word red in red, and I write the word yellow in yellow. And then I say, what color does it make? And it's orange, and I plot an orange pen, and I write orange. So, you're covering a lot of ground with this. You're teaching them how to read color words by doing them in the color of the word, and then you're helping them learn about primary and secondary colors, how we make secondary colors. So, using markers is another great way to do that.